God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
We celebrate the sacred mysteries. Let us call to mind our sins. I confess,
Almighty God, and to you, brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned
in my thoughts and in my words,
in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary and the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Today is also the feast of St. Francis Xavier. O God, who through the preaching of St. Francis Xavier won many people to yourself, grant that the hearts of the faithful may burn with the same zeal for the faith, and that holy tender heart, that holy church may everywhere rejoice in an abundance of offspring. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. On that day, this song will be sung in the land of Judah. We have a strong city. He sets up victory like walls and bulwarks. Open the gates, so that the righteous nation that keeps faith may enter in. Those of steadfast mind you keep in peace because they trust in you. Trust in the Lord forever, for in the Lord God you have an everlasting rock. For he has brought low the inhabitants of the height, the lofty city he lays low. He lays it low to the ground, cast it to the dust. The foot tramples it, the feet to the poor, the steps of the needy. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His steadfast love endures forever. It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to put confidence in mortals. It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to put confidence in princes.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Open to me the gates of righteousness, that I may enter through them and give thanks to the Lord. This is the gate of the Lord. The righteous shall enter through it. I thank you that you have answered me and have become my salvation.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Save us, we beseech you, O Lord. O Lord, we beseech you, give us success. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. We bless you from the house of the Lord. The Lord is God, and he has given us light.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
All please rise. Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Seek the Lord while he may be found. Follow him while he is near. Alleluia,
alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord. Lord.
When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain and sat down. His disciples came to him, and he taught them, saying, "Not everyone who says to me, 'Lord, Lord,' will enter the kingdom of heaven, but only the one that one who does the will of my Father in heaven. Everyone then who hears these words of mine and acts on them will be like a wise man who built his house on rock. The rain fell, the floods came, and the winds blew and beat on that house, but it did not fall, because it had been founded on a rock. And everyone who hears these words of mine and does not act on them will be like a foolish man who built his house on sand. The rain fell, the floods came, and the winds blew and beat against that house, and it fell, and great was its fall." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Jesus never stops in teaching in the days, disciples, and most of all to the people. Yesterday, we saw feeding the people, that they followed him for 3 days. With the eyes of compassion, he feeds them, gives them to eat. But today, he gives us what to eat, the most important food, and that is the Word of God. He went up the mountain and sat down, and he said to them, "Not everyone who says to me, 'Lord, Lord,' will enter the kingdom of heaven." It's very easy to pray, especially when we have these feelings and so enthusiastic. But then there is a moment in which even the prayer becomes very hard to do that. But still, if we know God's will, who says, "Pray all the time, be alert," that is the moment we need to do. It's very hard to do it. Now, those who say, "Lord, Lord," you will enter the kingdom of heaven. What is that we need to do? That today we need to do God's will and bring the God's kingdom. And God's kingdom comes through the mercy, through the acts of mercy, forgiveness, love. It's very hard when the Lord says, "I don't say to you to forgive 7 times only, but 70 times 7, and that means all the time. That is the Word of God. But only the one who does the will of my Father in heaven, and the one who hears his words, can be a good worker and also a good Christian who can be in God's kingdom and works in God's kingdom. It's not easy sometimes to do the word of God in action, to put it in action. But we need to have faith. And St. James will tell us, yes, you can say, "I have faith," but then show me your faith. But I show you my faith from my own actions. That's what we need to do. People of action. He himself was a person of action. That would be done, and then immediately had to go where? To the cross. Same thing must be. It's a moment in which we prepare ourselves and we take the example of the Virgin Mary, in spite that she didn't understand anything. How is possible, she says. But then she says, "That will be done in will," and she becomes the Mother of God, our Mother. Let's imitate her, especially this time of Advent. Let's imitate that the kingdom's kingdom come unto us, and that is Christ himself the King, and live in that kingdom, the kingdom of peace and joy, where God reigns with the Lord. Prepare our hearts to welcome his Son, Jesus, so that he can live in our hearts. Blessed are you, Lord God, for he has mercy and goodness we have received, the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and the work of human hands, to become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, the God of all creation, and mercy and goodness we have received in the wine we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, to become for us our spiritual tree.
Blessed be God forever.
Brothers and sisters, might that my sacrifice in yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his soul.
Receive, O Lord, this offering to bring to you in commemoration of St. Francis Xavier, and grant that as he journeyed to distant lands out of longing for the salvation of souls, so we too, hearing effective witness to the gospel, bearing the effective witness of the gospel, may with our brothers and sisters eagerly hasten toward you. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
This will be right and just our need and our salvation. Always and ever, give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he has to be as soon as his first coming, the lowliness of all human flesh, and so fulfilled the design he formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation, that when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Yea, living holy, O Lord, and when you have created rightly, give us the praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather the people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, the pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit which was to make whole in this gift we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at this command we celebrate this mystery. For in the night we betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to the disciples, saying, take this, all and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for. Same in our way when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this memory of me. The mystery of faith, where we eat this bread and drink this cup,
we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you thanksgiving, this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with the elect, especially with the Most Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, Saint Francis Xavier, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for our failing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity the pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis our Pope, Thomas our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Our departed brothers and sisters, and all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this world of life, give kind admittance to your kingdom, that we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him. O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by your divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our
Deliver us, Lord, that we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant the peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you say to our apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not in our sins, but in the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy to enter under my roof, but don't say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. And though I have already come, I embrace you, and you unite myself entirely to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. The body of Christ.
Amen.
I May your mysteries, O God, kindle in us the fire of charity, with which St. Francis Xavier burned for the salvation of souls, so that walking ever more worthily in our vocation, we may obtain with him the reward that he promised to those who labor well in the harvest. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
God be with you.
And with your spirit.
We may God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Saint Michael, Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God be with you, we humbly pray, and the love of which the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan, and all the evil spirits, cry about the world, seeking the ruin of souls.
Amen.
May peace and glorify the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Have a good night.
You too.